Hopefully this will be a better view to see what I'm doing here. So, you know, again, I don't want to, I've got my straight edge block clamped down to my scribe line, but I don't want to try to cut all the way to the scribe line to start off with. I like to step back a little bit and get a nicer cut, you know, instead of tearing and fracturing the wood. But see, I've got to cut down into this funnel shape because that's the way the pins are. So, but this is the outside, so this is the more important view. Okay, the same thing as before. The reason I didn't film me chopping this is I realized after I looked at the footage of me doing the other, it was my big head in the way, because I have to get close so I can see what I'm doing. But you know, I just came down here, used my guide, chopped this way, and then I came in with this wide one and then just paired these guys to my scribed line, and I guarantee you it's going to fit pretty close. But let me cut this other one, and then we're going to dry fit this thing together, and then I'm going to lay out where the and I'll probably go ahead and trim. Now I'm going to wait and trim those off after everything's glued up. I don't want to trim it yet, because I'll just pop that with the hand plane wherever those go. But the next thing I need to do is decide where the sliding dovetails are going to be. But I don't want to do that until I've got it dry fit and I can pull some measurements on the components that I'm putting in here. Well, I just got finished having a meltdown panic attack until I realized what I had done. So I made a mistake, but fortunately I'm lucking out that it's going to be okay. So when I mark this on the, when I place this board, remember in my clamp setup, on the end of my long curve pieces, I justified this bottom. But what I didn't take into account, and I should have thought of it, as I push this down, that's going to shift everything this way. So that's why I have this big gap here. So when I put this first one in, I just had a meltdown thinking that I had marked only one of them wrong. But then I realized that I did it consistent, so they're all shifted off by the same amount. Now I'm really lucky because I still have this much here at the top for me to trim. So there is the perfect reason to leave things wild on both ends, because I just didn't take into account as I drove this down, everything was going to shift down by that, you know, whatever that trigonometric calculation would be. So I really lucked out here. So this is just dry fit. I haven't paired or done anything, so I'm happy with this. You know, by the time I put some glue in there and clamp everything together, I think it's gonna go together real nice. So I actually, when I put these together, I put them in like this and I tapped them with a hammer to make sure that I wasn't gonna get this thing bent and racked and break my panel here. Let me explain what happened here and what I didn't take into account. So when I had this all in that clamp mechanism that you saw where I was marking these ends to then cut the pins, this is how I had it. And I'm just working away trying to get it done. I justified it, I lined it up on the bottom. But what I didn't take into account was this 17.5 degrees angle. So as I go in, everything's going to get shifted down off by that angle. And so I'm telling you I really lucked out on this, because I left my pieces wild long top and bottom. And I really lucked out because I cut this one flush, but since it moved longer as it went down, it shifted off the bottom. But everything's going to be fine because each one of them was done relatively the same way to the others, so it's going to be fine. I had a little meltdown right when it happened, but it's going to be all right. So I'm going to dry hang on, I see a couple little places that I need to clean here, so let me stop, and then I'm going to dry fit this end, and then I'm going to mark where my sliding dovetails be. I just have to dry fit this one time to make sure, but I just see I have a few little places trapped in the corner here that I need to clean. Okay, so let me just put this together and make sure it fits, that I don't crack anything. Try to get it started here. This board's got a little twist to it. There we go. The beauty of doing joinery like this is that even though this panel has moved, we've gone here in Texas, we've gone through some super humid, now back to desert dry days, so the panels have shifted. But whenever you do this kind of joinery, you know you can always kind of pull it back to straightness by the joinery that you use. That's really tweaked there. As I get one in. Okay, I think I got it. Both sides. Now let me try to get this side in. This is where a second set of hands would always be nice. Okay, that's started. So now I'm going to use, where's my? I'm gonna use my piece of lyptus and do it evenly. You know, I want to visually inspect that I'm not trying to jam one end too much, that I keep it symmetric. But I just want to see this go all the way down one time before I do it with glue. You know, if I can't get it to go right now, then I need to make an adjustment. The last thing I want to do is do it when I'm in the middle of a glue setup. Cracking one of my sides or my end panel, then I'm 100% positive that I can do it with glue. Okay, that's just a depression in the wood that I must have put in there. I thought at first it was a crack. It's not. Okay, that's pretty down right there. All right. Okay, that's good. That's good enough. I like it. So I've got to make a. Let's pull back and I'll lay it down. Well, it's upside down right now. If I pull it towards us here. But that's okay. That's not gonna have any effect on how the components are gonna go in. So let me just pull this down. Ooh, that's gonna be sweet. Looking good. Wow. So I gotta go in and take some measurements on my components and figure out exactly where. I'm gonna put two partitions in here. I'm gonna use sliding dovetails, and then I'm also, say for example, I know it's upside down right now, but if this was the top, then I'm also going to route a small dado about a quarter of an inch wide and about a quarter of an inch deep, and then I'm gonna make a corresponding cleat that goes on the back up high, and that's where I'm gonna have, that's where I can choose anywhere on 16 inch centers to put some big heavy screws into the wall to hold this cabinet up. And I'm not worried about it sagging because this won't sag, and then once the sliding dovetails go in, it won't sag, and then if it's pinned to the wall like that, it'll be rock solid.